We all know Darth Sidious as a devious, evil man who successfully again claimed the galaxy for the Sith Order after the groundwork was laid generations earlier by the likes of Darth Bane. We first encounter Palpatine at his prime in the dark side of the Force, as he's about to ascend as the one true Dark Lord that finally claims the galaxy for the Sith yet again. While there were Sith before Palpatine that progressed Bane's master plan, Palpatine was the last in the line of Sith Lords and the Dark Master that would put the final pieces into play. But how did Palpatine become a Sith Lord in the first place, and what dark deed did he commit to prove his loyalty to the Sinister Order? What was Palpatine's life like before he ever became a Sith Lord, and what was the man who would become the Emperor up to before he had ever heard of the Sith? In this video, we will explain what the early life of the Dark Lord Palpatine was truly like. Even at a very young age, Palpatine identified that he was different from those he grew up around, as well as his very family. Within him, Palpatine felt as though he was superior to everyone. Palpatine felt as though he was more intelligent and quick, but also that there was something else about him he could not yet put his finger on. One thing was for sure though in Palpatine's mind, he was better than everyone else, at everything. Despite having this strong feeling, Palpatine could never really identify what exactly made him feel this way. Around this time, Palpatine implored his father to become more involved in the politics of their homeworld of Naboo, as a means to gain more power for the Palpatine family as a whole. While a young Palpatine was growing up, back then known as Sheev, he and his father had a distant relationship, with his own father not even fully sure the boy was his own. After some time pushing his father, Palpatine saw he was unwilling to put in the time and effort to progress the family. Mainly, Palpatine saw this by his father's inability to progress in the political field of Naboo. This unwillingness to chase power eventually drove Palpatine to despise his father, as he saw how low his ambitions truly were. Already being extremely wealthy, Palpatine's father was content with his standing as far as influence and had no motivation to increase his reach or power. Because of this, Palpatine grew to absolutely hate his father as well as his mother allowed his father to remain where he was. At this point, Palpatine devised plans to one day destroy his mother as well as his father. His father for his ignorance and lack of motivation, and his mother for not pushing the family to become more. Ashamed, Palpatine even gave up his birth name of Sheev, disgusted that two weak-minded individuals had given it to him. From this point on, Palpatine demanded to only be referred to by the last name of the family, and from this day on, he was simply known as Palpatine. As an extremely young boy, through his schooling, Palpatine discovered the texts of the ancient Sith Empire, as the doctrine almost appeared to call out to him through the Force. However, at this point, Palpatine didn't even know what the Force was. All he knew is that he was fascinated by this ancient empire that had ruled so long ago. Using the wealth of his family, Palpatine began purchasing Sith artifacts, as he found himself almost completely agreeing with the teachings of the ancient order. The idea that power was the most important thing, and that those who did not hold such power should be utterly wiped from the star maps. As Palpatine learned more and more, all he desired was to one day become a Sith Lord. Despite all of the history that Palpatine researched indicating that the Sith were in fact gone, Palpatine knew otherwise. For years, Palpatine awaited the arrival of a Sith Lord on the planet of Naboo, as deep inside, he felt as though one day a Dark Lord would come for him, and he would be waiting. On one fateful day, the Dark Lord Darth Plagueis did in fact arrive on the planet of Naboo. Plagueis had come to Naboo in hopes of meeting a young nobleman who had helped him from the shadows during one of his devious endeavors. This young nobleman was Palpatine himself. Upon finding Palpatine, Plagueis thought it strange he could not sense the Force in him, but even more so that he could sense nothing at all. Not only could Plagueis not feel the potential of this boy, but his whole presence was a shadow in the Force. When Plagueis reached out to sense Palpatine, he got absolutely nothing, as if the boy wasn't even there. Interestingly, in the final moments of Plagueis' own master, Darth Tenebris, he experienced a vision of the rise and eventual fall of the Sith Empire, with the catalyst of the rise of the Dark Order being an individual clouded in complete darkness, an individual hidden by complete shadow. Finally experiencing this firsthand, Plagueis believed that he had found the true Sith Lord that would take over the galaxy. At first, Palpatine cared little for the individual he knew as Hego Damask, but after a lengthy conversation, ranging everywhere from architecture to the pursuit of knowledge and power, Palpatine became very curious as to the true origins of his new friend. However, Palpatine's father soon caught wind of the friendship between Damask, who was in fact Plagueis, and his son, and told Palpatine the two were not to see each other again. A short while later, Palpatine was sent off-world to study with his university. It was at this point that the long collision between father and son finally arrived, as Palpatine's father journeyed with his entire family to retrieve his young son. Once finding him, his father explained to Palpatine that he was to be removed from the political scene of Naboo entirely, and continue down a path that his father saw fit. Absolutely petrified by a meaningless life, Palpatine reached out to Plagueis, who seized the moment to test the true power of his young protege. Plagueis told Palpatine he had to do whatever was necessary, and that if his father stood in the way, he must be removed. Being forced off-world with his father, Palpatine told him he would not be finishing his schooling hidden away on some distant planet, and that he would one day rule Naboo and even more. It was here Palpatine finally revealed his bitter hatred for his father, telling him he believed he was an incapable leader of the family and a weak man altogether. Here, Palpatine's own father revealed he had despised his son since shortly following his birth, and that he had always been different and a disgrace to him and the family as a whole. Palpatine's father, however, went a step further, signing his own death warrant when he told his son he should have killed him long ago. Infuriated, for the first time, Palpatine fully embraced his raw power in the dark side of the Force, crushing the security guards of the family using the Force, and then turning his all-encompassing fury on his father and family members. The exact ability Palpatine used to kill his family, we will explore at a later date. After their deaths, Palpatine reached out to Plagueis for help, as the Dark Lord assured the young boy he would take care of it, and no one would ever discover the true fate of House Palpatine. Plagueis also revealed himself to Palpatine as a Dark Lord of the Sith, and offered him a place at his side, witnessing not only was the boy powerful, but unfeeling and merciless. "It is my will to join my destiny forever with the Order of Sith Lords. Then it is done. From this day forward, the truth of you, now and forevermore, will be Sidious." Palpatine would go on to learn from his master, even taking an apprentice of his own in the young Zabrak Maw, teaching him pieces of the doctrine of the Sith. "Do you feel the hate? It is the source of your strength. You still hate me. No matter. Today, you have delivered yourself into my hands. I have the power of life and death over you, Maul. Someday, you will hold that power over another. It is the honor of the Sith. You will devote yourself to the idea of domination." Using the wealth of Plagueis and political position of the Palpatine family, Palpatine was elected as a public servant, and eventually worked his way up to become a senator for his homeworld of Naboo, all with the guidance of his master Darth Plagueis from the shadows. And we all know the story of Palpatine from there. But what are your thoughts on the early life of the young Palpatine, and how he eventually killed his entire family and took over? As a bonus question, in your opinion, who is the most powerful Sith Lord of all time, and where does Palpatine rank? Always, thank you so much for watching. May the Force be with you, and have a great day.